नमस्कार, गुड मॉर्निंग टू माय इंडियन फैमिली एंड टू द इंटरनेशनल फैमिली, पर्टिकुलरली द नॉर्थ अमेरिकन्स जॉइनिंग अस, गुड इवनिंग। दिस इज द सेकंड डे ऑफ आवर योगा रिट्रीट विद मेडिटेशन। यस्टरडे वी गॉट आवरसेल्व्स टू अंडरस्टैंड द फर्स्ट कंपोनेंट ऑफ हीलिंग एंड दैट इज the relaxation response of the Harvard physician, and we saw how Iyengar, through a variety of restorative postures, brings that about. So we are looking at today bringing about a significant shift from a preoccupative world which has now gone into lockdown. So if, as I said yesterday, if your locus of control is external, the lockdown is a misery for a person whose locus of control is external. In yoga, we make the locus of control internal. And that internal is not just one's own intelligence, but the antaratma, antaratmin. And so let's begin with invoking the power that gives us this beautiful experience of an inner world. It's okay if the outer world is shut down. When we come from a deep connectivity with the antaryamin and make this in Iyengar, we bring this connectivity through the cells. So it is always a cellular celebration. And that's why we connect with a lot of scientists who talk about nitric oxide, who talk about a variety of benefits from meditation leading to the faith factor. And so we acknowledge God as the Alpha and Omega. And today I pray the prayer of the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. I want to dedicate this particular workshop this morning to my medical director who passed away of COVID. Others he saved, himself he could not save. We just pray for the repose of his soul as we do our first prayer. Asato ma sahat gamaya, tamaso ma jyotir gamaya, mrityor ma amrutam gamaya. Om shantihi, shantihi, Shanti. You may drop your head in Jalandhara Bandha, then drop your hands. Take a position to lie down, but I'm going to be demonstrating to you a position different from yesterday. Some years ago, almost in 1997, there was a healing and a faith and healing seminar in Boston. And somebody asked a question, a mind-body medicine person asked a question, what do these yogis do that we cannot do? And the answer from Myron Borisenko of the famous scientist of the psychoneuroimmunology, he said, they know how to trick the mind. So let's start with that principle. We have to trick the mind. Otherwise, we are still in a lockdown world that doesn't make any sense to us. We have to start building up an inner world. So let's show you how to do this. There are two ways of doing it. One is a little more difficult, because it all depends whether you are able to sit on your knees and fall back. But don't get discouraged when you go back. Don't get discouraged, because this is not expected. You can see now, I'm sitting in Virasana. Don't attempt this if you have never done this before, because it's necessary that you have some kind of practice. I'm not going to challenge you too much, because there is another posture substitute for this, where you, once you sit and you lie back, you keep a brick or a pillow and you relax. That's one. First, this is good. I must tell you this, at the age of 26, I couldn't do this. At the age of 78, going to be, I can do this. So Iyengar teaches us how to make your aging slow down. The affordable posture, the posture that you will be able to easily get, is Baddha, Supta Baddha Konasana. So keep your feet together. I hope you have Iyengar belts. If you don't have Iyengar belts, it is also okay, because you can lie back without using the belt. But you keep the belt around your, just above your gluteus, then you keep the belt around your feet and you tighten it, and then you lie back. So this is either of the postures, whether it is Supta Virasana or Supta Baddha Konasana, try it with the belt or without the belt. Let's spend 3 minutes in this posture. It helps to trick the mind, as I said, because when you breathe, you are not just using your diaphragm. In yoga, there are 5 areas of the breath body, pranamaya kosha, and that is called the pancha vayu. So now, as your feet are, as your legs are in the, either in Virasana or in Baddha Konasana, what you do is, when you're breathing in, feel the impact of this posture on the legs, with your, on your breath. And that is called the Apana Vayu area. So you are breathing with the awareness of your legs as you're breathing in. As you're breathing out, this is the area, the solar plexus, which you specially work on when you are exhaling. And if you don't work on when you are exhaling, then you are a person who is highly stressed. You cannot exhale, relax in the solar plexus, you are playing God. You are still not got out of the lockdown world. You are still upset that having, doing is not available to you, but Iyengar offers you being, how to come into the sense of who you are. So keep working on, keep working on the posture. As you breathe in, feel the legs. As you breathe out, feel the stomach. That's it for today. Those who don't have belts, as I said, try to keep your feet together, knees apart. Just for another 1 more minute. Those who are doing Virasana, Supta Virasana, can raise your hands up. Advanced students know that there are 4 stages in every posture. Arambhavastha, beginning, Ghatavastha, formation, and Parichayavastha, when you stretch your hands and explore the wisdom in the body as you breathe in and out. That is Parichayavastha. And finally, relax, where your human effort dovetails into God's grace.
Prayatna Shaitirya Ananta Samapatti Vyam, that is the principle, that our work has to be dovetailed into God's grace. That is why the final hymn is all about God's grace. Slowly, it's 3 minutes up. Slowly get your feet, Dojwan and Baddha Konasana, get your feet straightened up, remove the belt. Those who have Supta Virasana can sit upright and stretch your legs. Now we begin what we yesterday spoke of, Ujjayi Pranaya. Ujjayi has three components, as I said. Puraka inhalation, Rechaka exhalation, after the inhalation, before you dovetail the inhalation into the exhalation, there is a slight pause, that is Antarkumbhaka. And after the exhalation, there is a little longer pause, which is Bahyakumbhaka. We do this Ujjayi Pranayam for just about 3 minutes. I hope you have adjusted your pelvic rim. It's good to bend your knees and let the sacrum slide down. Then you can stretch your legs. Then work on the shoulders, pressurizing the shoulders downwards, opening up the armpits, the biceps opening up towards the ceiling, triceps moving towards the floor, and then you come to the Jalandhara Bandha, where your head is oriented towards the heart and the stem of the brain rests on the front edge of the brick or the pillow. That's the most important area of restiveness, for that is the amygdala that will trigger ultimately the nitric oxide, the Anandamaya Kosha. Take your time. Feel rested first. Remember, you are doing nothing. We are working with the wisdom within us. God resists the proud, only raises the lowly. So we have to be like little children. And that's what my Supreme Yogi said. That unless you become like a little child, you cannot access the kingdom of heaven. And again, as a Supreme Yogi, he said, the kingdom of heaven is within you. So let's work in this workshop to change the quality of our life by the quality of our meditation. If our meditation is not inclusive of the body, breath, and the mantra, we may not get the benefits that scientists today talk about when they say that our brains are wired to God. to get out of this posture, you bend your knees and roll off the bolster, either on the right side or left side, you roll off. And yesterday we did what was called chair shavasana. Today we are not going to use the chair, we are using the bolster itself. So we are using the bolster to explore the breath body. How do we do that? You keep your calves, as you kept your calves yesterday on the chair, you keep your calves rested on the bolster, the heels should be rested on the floor, and when you lie down, so now when you lie down, see that your head is oriented towards the heart, hands alongside the body, and we are going to start what that Marilyn Borisenko of the psychoneuroimmunology said, that these guys know how to trick the mind. Okay, let's see if we are more oriented towards the external locus of control, or we are ready to now start listening to the breath in a very special way. So as you're breathing in, feel the calf muscles rested. As you're breathing out, feel the solar plexus rested. Try to do that. Apana, Samana, Vayu, Ujjayi, Pranayama. So you will struggle to understand this. How does one feel the breath as you're breathing in your legs, in your calves? Well, develop that sensation awareness. So feel the sensation of the calves rested on the floor from your hip joints of the hips till your heels. Feel that area as though you have taken a spinal. That's shavasana, dead body. So do that as you're breathing in. And it's very easy for the exhalations to be felt in the solar plexus, Manipura chakra. You'll be able to feel also the muscles on either side of the spine resting on the floor. So this is the way to trick the mind. Bring it to observe minutely, to pay attention to the areas which the breath has to reach. In exhalation, you relax the solar plexus. In inhalation, you are resting your entire limbs, your legs, with the sensation of having taken a spinal. And now we come to the second combination, prana samana. So as you're breathing in, you feel all the three compartments of the respiratory system, vocal diaphragm, thoracic, pelvic. So take a deep, slow inhalation, exhalation, relax. Everything is relaxed. Always see that your kumbhakas are not encumbered. People with high blood pressure tend to overdo antar kumbhaka. People with low blood pressure forget to re-breathe after the rechak, after the exhalation. So bahya kumbhaka, antar kumbhaka, all have to be with a state of awareness. Remember, attention is Guruji's word for love. And remember also, you don't need to do some extraordinary things. As Mother Teresa said, But whatever you're doing it, do it with love. And here we are learning in this workshop how simple it is, but yet difficult. We can do complicated things easily, but when it comes to listening to our own body and breath, we are strangers to ourselves. Don't worry. Keep feeling. This is the main area of breathing. Inhalation, diaphragm, pranavayu area. Exhalation as before, samanavayu area. Then we come to the third area, which is called Dhyana Udana. So now this is a little difficult. But as you are breathing in, can you experience the incoming breath impacting the brain? Don't worry. Just try to smile as you are breathing in and see what happens to your facial skin. You will discover that you are so tense. So as you are breathing in, simulate a smile. As you're breathing out, drop the lower jaw without opening the mouth and relax the thyroid. Apana Samana was the legs and the stomach. Prana Samana was the respiratory, the diaphragm, including the cardiac muscles and the solar plexus. Now we come to a very subtle ways. The craniosacral people call this the primary breathing area, the brain. So as you are breathing in, let your smile percolate into the inner areas of the brain. You have to visualize, a lot of visualization in Iyengar. As you breathe in, relax your facial muscles, feel the brain. As you're breathing out, relax your throat, drop your lower jaw, keep your thyroid relaxed. Remember, thyroids are the Vishuddhi chakra. Vishuddhi chakra is a seat of, Vishuddhi means communication. And so many of us who are doing this workshop will discover that as you relax, and as you relax certain areas of the body in pranayama, in meditation, you begin to realize that you are getting back your gift of love. Vishuddhi is communication, another word for love. So now you do the whole body. As you are breathing in, apana, prana into the vyana, and as you are breathing out, udana into the samana. So those who don't understand Sanskrit, as you're breathing in, feel the rested calves, feel the rested heart, feel the rested brain. And as you're breathing out, feel the rested throat, feel the rested solar plexus, thyroids and solar plexus. Get a good Ujjayi pranayam now with the Pancha Vayu awareness. Apana prana into the vyana as you're breathing in. So involve the whole body. Involve the whole body as you're inhaling Uraka, as you're exhaling Rechaka. Keep returning to the breath. As the Zen master says, return to the breath, it's your best friend. It is the ability to work on the breath that is going to take away a lot of our mental ailments. As I said, alexithymia is an ailment that comes from not being able to feel our innermost traumas and emotions. So learn this in a simple way. As you're breathing in, return back to the breath. Keep returning to the breath as you return to the mantra later on in meditation. That completes our Panchavayu Ujjayi Pranayama. Now we go into a very simple pranayama that helps us to work on our high blood pressure. So keep, push the bolster, roll your body on your right side or left side and sit upright. And now we're going to use, those who have got a sofa or a chair can use for your, like we did yesterday, chair shavasana. With one difference, today when you are doing chair shavasana, you also keep, you know, the cotton bolster, hard cotton bolster is the best for this workshop. So obtain a hard cotton bolster. It is multi-purpose thing. Tomorrow we'll be using this for opening up the heart muscles. So what we're going to do now is mainly for people who are prone to have high blood pressure. So what about those who have got low blood pressure? Well, you just continue doing your Ujjayi Pranayama. But let's give the people who have high blood pressure an instrument to really calm down, an instrument to really make ourselves completely available to the pull up to God's providence. So keep your calves on the chair, keep your head on a pillow or on a brick, keep the bolster on the shin bone and get a sense of restiveness. To get into shavasana again, before we start what is called Viloma Pranayam by 2, Viloma Pranayam 2 by a Kumbhaka. So we are going to be working on exhalation, retentions in a very systematic way. All of us together, we can do it according to our own rhythm capacity. So I will just describe it and then we will do it together. You take a deep inhalation and we start this by your Kumbhaka, Viloma Pranayam 2. And as you start exhaling, after a couple of seconds, you hold the breath. Then you, how long do you hold the breath? If you're a high blood pressure patient, you can hold the breath for 3 to 4 seconds or 3 to 4 counts. Then you continue breathing and again hold the breath, again for 3 to 4 counts. Then you slightly inhale and fully exhale and hold the breath. Again for 3 to 4 counts. So now you understood the structure of a Viloma Pranayam 2, bringing down our blood pressure, regulating our blood pressure, because we are now doing mindful breathing in a very special way. So first do shavasana. You can never start pranayama unless you completely relax the body. And now we begin the Viloma Pranayama by Kumbhaka too, but each one do it according to your own capacity. We take a deep inhalation, start exhaling, hold the breath. Continue exhaling, hold the breath. Slightly inhale and fully exhale and hold the breath. Normal breathing. Each one does it according to your own capacity and rhythm. Now in normal breathing, Shavasana, as your breath comes to Ujjayi, it won't if you are strained. So if you have paused each time for more than 3 or 4 counts, lessen it. Now do Shavasana, Ujjayi Pranayama, and try Vayu Kumbhaka Viloma Pranayama 2 for the second time. Take a deep inhalation and begin. Then relax. Always remember that Vayu Kumbhakas are done 2 in the exhalation process. The second time, you slightly inhale before you completely exhale and hold the breath for the final time and then normal breathing. By now, you should have come to a normal Ujjayi Pranayama. Advanced students may be able to pause in Shavasana, Ujjayi Pranayama within 1 or 2 breaths. So they can do multiple Viloma Pranayama 2 by your Kumbhakas. All together now for the third time, the last time, take a deep inhalation. Start exhaling, hold the breath. Continue exhaling, hold the breath. Slightly inhale and fully exhale and hold the breath. Normal breathing. Shavasana. There are 2 types of Shavasana. Let us see if some of you are able to observe that. It needs a very sharp yogic eye. It is called the Antarchakshu, the inner eye. How many of you can see that as a result of doing Shavasana with the body, you feel a sense of restedness? And now that you are able to let go of the breath also, as you let go of the breath, there is a different type of sensation within us. We can feel an infinite reservoir of stillness. But that's very important. Shavasana of the body is easy. Shavasana of the breath needs spiritual maturity. I'm sorry I use this word, but we are all learning how to use the body for our spiritual well-being. And when you are able to feel the freedom in the breath after Ujjayi and Viloma Pranayama 2, you are in a state of stillness. Psalm 46 says, be still and know that I am God. So aham tatvam asi. Try to capture that if you can for a little while. And now we come to take a position for meditation. When you take a position for meditation, you must keep your spine upright, but relax. So don't feel that you have to be stressed. Never keep your spine. You may also choose to keep your, so you can sit in Virasana, Vajrasana, Sukhasana, simple cross legs, or you can sit in Ardha Padmasana, which is Siddhasana, or you can sit fully in Padmasana. The great advantage of Padmasana is that when your foot pressurizes the opposite thigh, you get a tremendous rise in your diaphragm. So, but don't bother if you cannot sit. Wherever you are sitting, please remain in a relaxed but upright position. And keep your so keep your spine upright. Now, how do you do that? When you're breathing in, can you get in touch with the muscles all around the coccyx? That's the Mooladhara Chakra. It's easy to do that as you're breathing in, and that contracts the muscles of the all around the coccyx, sending the energy upwards. And when you're exhaling, feel the natural relaxation of the lower abdomen. And that is called the Uddiyana Mudra. Uddiyana is to keep the energy flying up. And after an inhalation, occasionally, remind the brain to be oriented towards the heart, the Antar Chakshu, which I spoke about, as to make us aware of orienting our thinking brain towards the heart. Now, you don't have to completely bend your head like that, but you have to keep your internal awareness. So the medulla oblongata, the cerebellum, does get a little extended as you make the skull look downwards. So that's we are set to practice meditation. As I said yesterday, all practices of meditation, the component of dharana. And for that, we use the word, a sacred phrase, or just a plain phrase. People who don't have any special religious leanings can use, as the Cloud of the Unknowing book says, the British author says, just use one. But we have in India so many popular mantras like Hari Om, Narayana. The World Community for Christian Meditation, of which the Dalai Lama and Rowan Williams are members, we are in 130 countries. We use the mantra called the Aramaic word Maranatha, that is, come Lord. You can use the word
like, you know, just shalom, any word. But the mantra is important because you synchronize it with your breath. Later on, I will teach you how to synchronize this so that the sympathetic nervous system and the parasympathetic nervous system also have a particular equation. And that makes all the difference to the heart rate variant, HRV. But that in the days to come. Today, let's keep it simple to just learn how to do your bandhas internally. Breathing in, Mula Bandha. Breathing out, Uddiyana Bandha. Occasionally, after a deep inhalation, by Antar Kumbhaka time, as you are going to be exhaling, there is a slight pause. During that pause, orient your brain towards the heart. We keep this for, as I said, for the first half of this workshop, we will be maintaining the meditation time of 15 minutes. But the second half of the workshop, we will extend it to 20 minutes, which is the appropriate time to be practiced as meditators. And we begin with the prayer. Heavenly Father, Divine Mother, open our hearts to the silent presence of your Spirit in our hearts. Lead us into that mysterious silence where your love is revealed to all who call, either Hari Om, Narayana, Maranatha, Shalom, Allah.
Ooh.
Shantihi. Shantihi. Shantihi.